Hello people, in this video tutorial we will be discussing about SciPy graphs. So this video tutorial is not only limited to the SciPy graphs, we will be going in depth and we will be discussing about agency matrix and we will be discussing about connected components. Okay, then we will move on to the Dijkstra method, which is a very famous method in SciPy. So we will learn how we can import the Dijkstra method, and then we will go on to the Floyd-Warshall method, Bellman-Ford method. Okay, then we will also discuss about the depth first order and the breadth first order. So without wasting further time, let's get into it. We have a lot of things to discuss. Okay, so as I said that I'll be explaining to you in depth what is a adjacency matrix. Okay, so let us see what do we mean by, you know, working with graphs. Okay, so graphs are an essential in data structure. Graphs are essential in data structure, that we all know. So SciPy provides us with the module called scipy.sparse.csgraph. I'm highlighting it over here. So this is the name of the module, scipy.sparse.csgraph, for working with such data structures. Now, adjacency matrix is a n into n matrix, okay, where n is the number of elements in a graph. So let me just scroll down. So let's say that there are three elements, A, B, and C. Okay, there are three elements, A, B, and C. A and B is connected with weight 1. So I have tried to draw a small diagram kind of thing over here. So as you can see that in the diagram, I have shown that A and B, which is A and B, they are two elements. So it is connected by 1. So the weight is 1. A and C is connected with weight 2, and C and B is not connected. Okay. A and B is connected by 1. A and C is connected with 2, and C and B is not connected. Okay. So now let us see. So since A and A is not connected, so we have written 0 over here. B and A is connected by weight 1, so 1 is written over here. Okay. A and C is connected by weight 2, so weight is written over here. 2 is written over here. Okay. Again, A and B is connected with 1, weight 1, so 1 is written over here. B and B is not connected, so 0, and C and B is not connected, so 0. A and C is connected with weight 2, so 2 is written over here. Okay. B and C is not connected, so 0, and C and C is not connected, so 0. Okay. So now if this part is clear, then we will move on to the next part and we will discuss most used methods for working with adjacency matrices, okay, or also known as agency matrices, okay, however you pronounce it. So the first method which we are going to discuss is the method of connected components. Okay, the method of connected underscore components, that is only the name of the method. So for doing it, we will have to import certain modules and certain libraries inside a program. So let me import. So the very first thing which I'm going to import is the NumPy library. So import NumPy as np. Okay. Let me scroll up a little bit. Import NumPy as np. And then we will be importing SciPy, few modules from SciPy. So SciPy dot sparse dot cs graph. Okay, from scipy.sparse.csgraph, I want to import connected components, connected underscore components. Okay, so let me execute it, shift and enter. So a number has appeared over here. That means that I have successfully imported these two. Okay, one more thing I forgot. I also want to import the CSR matrix from SciPy. So from scipy.sparse, I want to import the CSR matrix, CSR underscore matrix. All right, we will again execute it. So now we have successfully imported all the relevant modules and libraries. Okay, now we will create an array. Okay, so the array will be same as this one. this array over here, 0, 1, 2, 1, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0. It will be a 3x3 array. So how do we create an array? As we have already seen in the NumPy tutorials, I have shown how we can create an array and stuff. So array arr is equal to np dot array. Okay. So we will put in the elements. So 0, 1, 2 in the first row, 0, comma, 1, comma, 2. We'll put a comma, come to the second row. The elements in the second row is 1, 0, 0. So 1, comma, 0, comma, 0. And in the third row, we have 2, comma, 0, 2, comma, 0, comma, 0. All right, we have successfully created our array. Okay. Now we will be writing new array or new R is equal to CSR underscore matrix. And inside. Okay. Now we will be writing print and the connected components method together. So we can write it separately also, but just to save us a little time, I have combined these two together. So connected underscore components . Okay, let's see what do we get. Okay, so we are getting, this is the output. Okay, this is the output. So basically what have we done? We have tried to find all the connected components with the connected components method. Okay, for this array. All right, moving on. Now we will be discussing about the Dijkstra method. Okay, we'll be discussing about the Dijkstra method. Okay, so for using the Dijkstra method, the very important thing is to import the Dijkstra module. So for importing the Dijkstra module, we will be writing from scipy.sparse.csgraph import Dijkstra. Okay, so let us do that. From scipy.sparse.csgraph import Dijkstra. So the spelling of Dijkstra is Dijkstra. Okay, so from scipy.sparse.csgraph import Dijkstra. We have already imported NumPy as np and CSR matrix, so that will be it. So shift and enter. Okay, so there is some spelling error. Okay, so we have successfully imported the Dijkstra from scipy.sparse.csgraph. Okay, now I will be working with the same array. Okay, I'll be working with the same array, so I can just to save us time, I can just copy paste from here. Okay, Control C, Control V. Okay, so I have copy pasted this, and now new array is equal to CSR underscore matrix inside ARR. Okay, and I'll be printing and combining the Dijkstra method together. So I'll be combining the Dijkstra method inside of our print statement. So print, and inside I'll be writing Dijkstra Dijkstra. Okay, Dijkstra, and I'll be writing new array, comma, return underscore predecessor. Okay, so the return underscore predecessors this will be true. I'll be explaining you in a while after writing that what does each word and each line of code means. So just be patient. Okay, then I'll be putting a comma and I'll be writing indices is equal to 0. Okay, done. So without first let me explain and then I will execute the statement. Okay, so Dijkstra method is basically a method to find the shortest path in a graph. Okay, from one element to another. Dijkstra method is a method to find the shortest path in the graph from one element to another. It takes three arguments. The first argument being return underscore predecessor, which I have written over here. And then it takes the indices and then it takes the limits. Right now, I have not given the limit over here. Okay, so return underscore predecessor is a Boolean value. It can either be true or it can be false. So true to return the whole path. If we want to get the whole path of traversal, then true, otherwise false. So right now, I have given true over here. Then the second argument is indices. So indices is 0. So indices is nothing but the index of the element to return all path from that element only. Okay. And then we have the limits. Right now, I haven't specified any limit. Okay. So the use of Dijkstra method is to find the shortest path in a graph from one element to another. Okay. Now that we know the lines of code that we have written over here. So let me execute shift and enter. Okay. So this is the output. This is the output. Okay. Moving on. Now we have something known as the Floyd-Warshall method to find the shortest path between all pairs of elements. Okay. So Dijkstra method was to find the shortest path from element 1 to 2. But Floyd-Warshall method is to find the shortest path between all pairs of elements. So for using the Floyd-Warshall, first we will have to import the Floyd-Warshall. So from scipy, from scipy dot sparse dot cs graph import Floyd underscore Warshall. Okay, now other libraries we have already imported, so just be careful with the spelling Floyd-Warshall. So shift and enter, we have successfully imported, and now we can use the Floyd-Warshall method to find the shortest path between all pairs of elements. So the array which I have taken over here, I'll take the same array. Okay, so just I'm copy pasting it from here. Okay, now I will combine the Floyd-Warshall method and the print statement. So I'm writing print and inside I'll be writing Floyd underscore Warshall. And inside I'll be writing new array, comma return predecessor. I want to be true. So return underscore this I want to be true. Okay, now I'll be executing, so shift and enter and we have got the output. Okay, we have successfully found out the shortest path between all the pairs of the elements. Okay, all right, now okay, now we go on to the Bellman-Ford method. Okay, so what is Bellman-Ford method? So in Bellman-Ford method, we can find the shortest path between all pairs of elements, but this method can handle negative weights as well. Okay, so the significance of Bellman-Ford method is that it can handle the negative weights as well. Okay, so for using Bellman-Ford, we'll have to import Bellman-Ford module first. So from scipy dot sparse dot cs graph import bellman underscore fort. Okay, be careful with the spellings. Okay, so shift and enter, done. Now we will be using the same array, so I'll copy paste once again. Okay, so I'll copy paste once again, control C, control V. Okay, control V. All right, and now I'll combine the print statement and the bellman fort and. So I'll just copy this print statement as well, control C, control V, and instead of Floyd Warshall, I'm just writing over here bellman fort. Okay, so bellman underscore fort. Okay, rest everything is fine, and we will also mention the indices over here. So the indices is equal to 0. All right, shift and enter, and we have successfully used the bellman fort method to find the shortest path from element 1 to element 2 with a negative weight. Okay, all right, so we'll meet again in the next video, and I'll come up with some new topics of SciPy.